Yo, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Today we're gonna do another workout. I've been naming these videos, I don't know what to call them, so I just named them my fitness journey. So this would be episode 2. Again, I'm gonna be hitting them shoulders like that. Last time I was doing these, but I had too much weight, so I couldn't do the proper technique and so forth. I've lowered the weight because to me, I think if you have all the weight in the world but if the technique's not proper, you're not hitting the right muscles, right? Or at least that's how I feel, like that's where my mind goes. Like, you know what, let me lower the weight, get the technique correct so I could hit the right spots and so forth. So I'm gonna do some of that, and I gotta hit the arms, man. I gotta get some curls and some triceps, and eventually we're gonna start getting to the stomach. I do want to work on the stomach as well, but we'll do that today. Then we're gonna hit the scale. Once we hit the scale, we'll be done for the day after a workout and so forth. The good thing is the heat wave has died down. We were at like 98 at 102, and I was wearing a sweater and a sweat bag and so forth. So I was really like at about 115. The good thing about that, I was, you know, burning mad calories and keeping some muscle, right? The bad thing about it is that now that the heat wave has died down, I'm not going to be shredding the calories as easy. But it'll be more comfortable when I'm working out, right, and not feeling exhausted and like dehydrated and so forth. So it's a balancing act, right? There's pros and cons to it. So yeah, that's what we got for today. So let's get the workout going. All right, time for the weigh-in. Let's check the scales.
All
right, so we clocked in at about 175.4. I started this back in towards the end of April, and I was at almost 196. So yeah, we're at 175.4. I'd like to get back to 170. If I can, traditionally my weight has always been around 155, so I gained quite a bit of weight, and if I could get back to around 170, 165, I'll be happy with that. So I like where I'm at this moment, and today what I wore, just hopped out the shower, the Parma Bergamota Di Calibra. Nice fresh scent for the summertime. I live in California, so it's hot almost year round, right, the majority of the year. So this works for me basically the majority of the year. It's a nice fresh scent. Bergamot, if you're familiar with it, it's almost like a lemon and lime type of thing. It doesn't smell like lemon or lime, but you know how lemon and lime have similarities. This would go under that family, in my opinion. It's a citrus, and this smells fresh, and it lasts pretty long. I get almost 8 hours with this, 7 to 8 hours. So it's a great deal. You can find it at fragrancebuy.com and what's the other one? You can find it on another network. I think Fragrance X. About $70 for 100 mil, great price for what you're getting here. It's one of the longer lasting freshies, and it smells real good, real high quality stuff here. This is one I recommend if you live somewhere where it's hot weather the majority of the time. It's very refreshing, as you could tell from the blue bottle. It tells you it's a you know, summer type scent. All right, guys, that's all I got for you guys today. Hopefully you liked the video. If you did, go ahead and hit that like button, and I'll check you guys out next time.